Hello everyone, let's see how to use Microsoft Teams to conduct online classes with the help of laptop. Friends, first of all, you have to download Microsoft Teams app software. To download it, click on Google Chrome or any other browser that you use. Here, you have to type Microsoft Teams download for Windows 10, or you can type any other if you are having any other Windows. You will get these search results. Go to third link. Now click on this option, free download. Then click on this button. Now you click on this button. Now click on the download for desktop option. Now click on download Teams button. The download process will start as you can see here. After downloading, you have to go to this PC and open downloads. You will see this is the Teams software that we have to use. Now double click on it to start installation. After installation, friends, you will get this screen. Here you have to type your ID that you get from your organization. The ID should be your Microsoft account. Friends, after typing your ID, click on sign in. Now enter your password. Then I uncheck this box and click on OK button. Then click on done. It will take some time. Friends, once you log in, you will get a screen like this. Here are various options available. First option is activity. All the notifications you will get in this area. Next is chat option. When you chat with someone, your chatting will be saved here. Teams option, it is used to create new teams. Assignment option is given so that you can share assignment with your students. Calendar option shows your timetable and you can schedule meetings from here. Call option is used to call a particular member. File option is used for file sharing. So let's start with Teams option. Friends, Teams works like a classroom. Consider you want to conduct online class on daily basis for a particular group of students. So you can create a team with those students and you can schedule a meeting. So friends, let's see the steps to create team. Here is a button, join or create team. You can click on this button to create a team. Click on create team. There are four options available. Class, if you want to create a team with your students. Second option is for professional learning community, if you want to create a team with your colleagues. Staff, if you want to create a team of your staff members. And other, if you want to create a team with your friends and any other purpose. Right now, I am choosing class option. Type the name of the team. Here, I am writing class 5. You can give any description here. Click on next button. Friends, now you have to add some students and teachers to your class. For example, there are 4 more teachers that will conduct classes in this particular team. So you can type their names and add them. But one thing you have to remember, you can add only that person who is having account on Microsoft Teams. Right, for example, I am typing a name, I choose one person and this person must be having the account on Microsoft Teams, that's why I can see his name here. Then I click on add button. After adding all the students and teachers, click on close. Here you are getting a notification. Friends, see, I have created a team with the name class 5. That is my work area. Whatever work I perform in this particular class, I will get a message here. Right, by default there is one channel, journal channel. I can create different channels in this particular team. For example, I click here, I click on add channel and I choose here channel name as computer. I can give any description here and click on this icon, automatically show this channel in everyone's channel list. It means all the students and teachers that are added to this particular team, they can see this channel. Then I click on add button. Look friends, I am having a channel computer. Right? It means whenever I want to conduct my computer class, I will conduct with the help of this channel. Now let's see the steps to create this particular meeting. Now friends, look here, you can see various options are available here. Right? You can chat with your students here, you can share any file, you can meet here also and you can give praise to the students. For example, I am writing a message, hello students. I have given a message. This message will be reflected to all the students who are in this particular team. Now, if I want to give praise to any student, I can click here, send praise to people. You can choose any praise that you want to give to any student, like if a student has done a very good task, you can give awesome. Then write the name of the student to whom you want to send this praise. I am typing the name of a student, click on preview and then click on send. And students, when you send praise to the student will get a notification regarding that, right? Now let's see how to schedule meeting and how to conduct meeting. We go to calendar option. Friends, on top right side, you are getting two buttons, new meeting and meet now. I am scheduling my meeting for the first time, so I will click on this new meeting icon. Write the name of the meeting. I write computer class. I can type any attendees here, but I am not typing here. You can choose your date, time and end time. If you want to schedule for 1 hour, you can choose 7 p.m. Or if you want to schedule for half an hour, you can choose 6:30. Now you can choose doesn't repeat. It means you want to schedule this meeting for today only. Every weekday means Monday to Friday, daily, weekly, whatever frequency you want, you can choose. I am choosing every weekday. Now there is an option add channel. From here I am choosing team class 5 and from here I am choosing channel computer, right? And then I click on send button. Now my one meeting has been scheduled. Friends, see, as I click on send, I am getting this option here. In calendar, it is showing that at 6 p.m. I am having a meeting. I double click on this meeting. Now, if I right click on this link, I will get a direct link of this meeting. With the help of this link, I can invite any person who is not member of this team, but still I want him to join my meeting. Let's see. Right click, copy link. This is the link of my meeting. I can share this link with any other person. Now I click on close button. Friends, when we schedule a meeting and when it is the time to start the meeting, our student will get a notification regarding that. So now consider you have scheduled a meeting and now you want to join that meeting. How can you join the meeting? Double click on the meeting. There is a join button. So next time you will not click on new meeting. Daily this option will be available in your calendar. You will double click on that and you will click on join button. When I click on join, I am getting this screen. It means I am ready to start my meeting. I can click on join now. Friends, here first option is for camera. I have disabled the camera. That's why here is a line. You can click on it to keep your web camera open. Second button is for mic. You can click on it to mute yourself. Third option is for sharing your content. Friends, consider you want to share a text file or any other document with your students, so you have to take care that that document is already open. Now click on this share button. Here you will get link for all the open documents. You can choose your file. See, now your students can see this particular file that you are sharing. If you want to stop sharing, bring your cursor at the top. You will get this stop presenting, or you can click on this button stop sharing again. It will stop the sharing. Next, three dots, it gives you more options. Start recording option is used to record your session so that whatever work you are doing, you are saying, everything will get recorded. Raise hand option is used by the participants if they want to ask any question. Next option is for chat. Click on chat. You can write any message here that you want to share with your students. Show participant will show you participant list, like you can see how many participants are there. Friends, last option, hangup. This option is used when you want to end your meeting, right? So in this way you can conduct your online class. Friends, Microsoft Teams provides you one very good option to mark attendance. When you go to show participant option, you can see this button, this download button. This download button helps you to download the attendance of your session. Click on that. Here it is showing one file was downloaded and downloading, right? After your session, you can go to downloads option of your computer. In downloads, you will get this file, meeting attendance list. Look, here you can see how many participants have joined. Here I was alone. I was a single participant, that's why it is showing my name only. Friends, there is one more option. When you click on share, you get an option to share whiteboard. Click on that. I am clicking on this button. Use the whiteboard in this app. For first time, it will take some time. Look, you can choose any pen here. If you want to show any graph, you can use it. And friends, you can use eraser also to erase particular thing. If you want to use it to draw any diagram, or a maths teacher wants to show something, you can use it easily. And if you click on the stop presenting, you will come back to your normal screen. Right, friends? Now, if you want to end your meeting, click on this button. You will get the message that your class was conducted and it ended in this time. Now friends, let's see one more option, assignments. Go to assignment option. With the help of assignment, you can share assignment files with your students. Students can give response to it and submit back. Now choose the channel, in which channel you want to put the assignment. Get started. Now you will get this create button. Here are three options: assignment, quiz, and from existing. Because I am creating my first assignment, so I will choose this. If you want to create quiz, you can choose this also. Now write the name of the assignment, write computer assignment 1. If you want to give any instruction, you can give instructions here. Then click on add resources. Here you get various options. First option, OneDrive, means if you have saved any assignment file in your drive, you can choose from there. Class notebook is also available in Microsoft Teams. If you have put any file there, you can choose that file. Link option is used when you directly want to link any assignment that is already uploaded on the internet. New file option is used to create a new file. Teams means you want to link any file that is already uploaded on the Teams. But right now I am choosing upload from this device. Now you browse your assignment file. I am choosing this assignment 1. Click on open. Now click on done. Friends, my assignment file has been uploaded, but can you see what is written here? Students can't edit. It means students will get only read-only document. They cannot edit it. But if you want that your students can edit this file, they can put their response in that. Then click on this three dots, and from here choose student edit their own copy. Look, students edit their own copy. Now student will be able to edit this file. If you want to grade the students, you can write points. It is a 10 marks assignment or 100 marks, whatever you want to give. Now see here, post assignment notification to this channel. You want to put the notification in journal or in your particular channel of computers. And click on edit, because I want that all the notification related to computers should go in this channel. Done, right? Now click on the assign button. I have created my one assignment. Now I go back to Teams. Look, friends, you can see there is one assignment. I have not changed the due date, that's why it is showing by default June 14th. If you want, you can change it. Go to assignment. Choose your team. Here is one assignment. I double click on that. Is showing my assignment. I click on edit assignment. That is due date. If you want to change due date to next week, I choose from here update. Now go back to your Teams, and here you can see that your due date of the assignment is June 20th. Assignment due date has been changed. Right, so friends, whatever work you perform in this particular channel, you can see that work here. In the same way, students will also get the notification in this area. So friends, in this way, you can schedule your meeting and you can share assignment with students. But sometimes it happens that our student becomes presenter of the meeting. If you want to avoid this, what you have to do? We have to change our meeting option. Go to calendar. Here is our meeting. Click on that. Here you can see one option available. That is meeting option. It will redirect to Microsoft website. Friends, here you have to log in with your credentials. After login, you will get this screen. Here you can see the option who can present. Instead of everyone, you can choose only me or specific people or people in my organization. So instead of that, the safest option is only me. It means only you can present. Done. Now student cannot become presenter of your meeting because you have done this setting here. Right, friends? Thank you so much.